This week's parasha that we're reading the Torah is Shemot, the first parasha of the book of Exodus. And one of the most important things in this parasha is that the Redeemer of Israel, Moshe Rabbeinu, is born. He appears on the scene of the Torah for the first time in this week's parasha. At the time of his birth, his mother, Yocheved, when she gives birth to him, that's actually a little bit in secret, because the power had decreed that all the children should be thrown into the Nile. So it was all in secret. And when she gave birth to her son, Moshe Rabbeinu, she looked at the newborn babe, and it says in Hebrew, Vatelo tokitofu, that she saw that he was good. And then she hid him away for 3 months. All of the commentaries say that every mother loves her child, and every mother, when she sees a newborn baby, immediately embraces, hugs the baby, and for sure he's good, and he's the very best gift that God can give a mother. So what does it mean, what does the Torah mean to emphasize the word good, that she saw that he was good? There must be some special meaning, some unique meaning to that word good in this context of the birth of Moshe Rabbeinu. So there is a whole array of different commentaries, different meanings, what the goodness of Moshe Rabbeinu. Let's have in mind that Moshe Rabbeinu is the Redeemer of Israel. He was the first Redeemer, and his soul returns to be the final Redeemer, which is the Moshiach. So everything that is said about Moshe Rabbeinu is very pertinent to our understanding and to our connection to Goel Yisrael, the Redeemer of Israel. So the fact that the very first descriptive term that is used about him is that he is good, that must be something most essential to the very being, the core being of the Redeemer of Israel. So in short, we can go through 7 different meanings that are given by the sages, what that word good refers to when Moshe Rabbeinu is first born. And as we usually do when we discuss a whole array of commentary on a certain concept, we try to arrange it and to model it based on a Kabbalistic model. And if there are 7 different interpretations, so those interpretations must correspond to the 7 emotive powers of the heart, which are in Hebrew, chesed, gvura, tiferet, netzach, hod, yisod, malchut. And in English, the translations are usually loving kindness and might and beauty and victory and acknowledgement and foundation and kingdom. So let's see how the sages give 7 different interpretations to the word good at Moses' birth and how it corresponds to all of his emotive character. The first interpretation, which is the one that Rashi brings, because Rashi is the most literal commentary on the Chumash, on the Bible, he says that good refers to the very first time that good was mentioned in the Torah. At the very beginning of creation, it says that God created the first thing as a light on the first day. The first day of creation corresponds to the first of the 7 emotions, which is love, loving kindness. And he created light, he looked at the light, and he saw that the light was good. So it's very, very similar. Just like God created light and looked at the light and saw that the light was good. So exactly the same way, Yocheved, the mother of Moshe Rabbeinu, gave birth to Moshe, her son, and she looked at him. That's what it says, Vatelo, until she looked at him, and she saw that he was good. So there must be some relation between Moses, his birth, and the appearance of new created light. So the sages say that indeed, at the moment that he was born, came out of the womb of his mother, the whole womb became full of light. That's the first interpretation. The fact that she saw that he was good means that the light filled, encompassed all of space around Moshe Rabbeinu. So since this is derived, this interpretation is derived from the comparison of his birth to the creation of the first day, which is chesed, this light, this first light that appears, that is his essential loving kindness, his midah, his character of chesed. And second interpretation reads that we know that Moshe Rabbeinu was born in the seventh month, or actually the beginning of the seventh month of pregnancy, 6 months in 1 day. And the mother, when she gives birth so early to a baby, it could be a miscarriage. She doesn't know if the formation of the baby is complete or not complete. Also, it says that she was a very old woman at this time. Not everybody realizes, but she was 130 years old. And for a very old woman to give birth to a child, according to nature, very often the child will be weak. But when she looked at her new baby, Moshe Rabbeinu, not only was he complete, but he also appeared to be strong. This is actually the interpretation of Targum Yonatan, one of the translations into Aramaic of the text. That even though he was born early and was born to a very old mother, but he was complete and strong. So the fact that, and that's the meaning of the word good, that she saw that he was good, meaning that he was full, he was completely formed, well-formed, and very strong. Almost like a grown child. So that interpretation corresponds to might, because the word that is used is actually strength. She saw that he was strong. There's something about good. There's something about the word good, to be good, that you're a person is strong. To be good, you have to be strong. The next interpretation, which is close to this one, but it's a different interpretation, that very often the word good in Hebrew in the Tanakh and the Torah means beautiful. Like, for instance, when the Torah describes Rebecca, also a young child at the age of 3, before she married Yitzchak, Isaac. So the Torah uses the word Tovat Mara, she was of goodly appearance, very, very much of goodly appearance. So many of the commentaries say that the child was simply the most beautiful child, even though, as we said before, every mother loves her child. But there was some special beauty of this child that no other mother experienced in looking at her newborn babe. So this, obviously, the interpretation that good in this context means beautiful, that corresponds to the third of the emotive sefirot, which is beauty, tefillah. The next two of the sefirot normally go together as a pair. They are netach and hold. And just to explain in short what are the difference between these two and the three previous ones. The three previous ones are essential to one's own personality or one's own character. It's to say that someone is good means there's something innately, inherently good about this person. So either it's good that he's full of light, that he is full of light, or he's strong, or that he's beautiful. Those are all attributes that describe him. But when we come to the next two sefirot, and that's the hold, they are more pragmatic, meaning that if I say that someone is good at the level of netzach or hold, the next two of the sefirot, which is victory and acknowledgement, I mean that he's good for something. Something is good for, he's able to perform, to achieve, and to succeed in a certain function that he's good for. So actually, there are two now interpretations that do go together as a pair. The sages say that she saw that he was good to become a prophet. She had some sense, some intuition. The mother has intuition. She looked at her new baby and she said that he is Ra'ui L'Neviut. This baby is good to become a prophet. What is the prophecy of Moshe Rabbeinu? Through him, he is the channel through whom we receive the Torah, the greatest prophecy of all. There's another interpretation. She looked at her baby, and she says, he is good to be the redeemer of Israel, to redeem the Jewish people. Chazal, the sages in a different context, say that Moshe Rabbeinu is called good is a very beautiful phrase, idiom, that they say, may good come and receive good from good to good. May come good is Moses, he's called good in this when he's born. And receive good, the Torah, his prophecy, the Torah is called good. From good, God is the author of the Torah, and he is the absolute good. To good, the Jewish people are also called good. So this is like an extended pun on words that the sages say, may good come and receive good from good to good. So that all has to do with the Netzach property of Moshe Rabbeinu. Because it says in Kabbalah that prophecy comes from this sefirah, this power, this mode of power of victory. Victory also means eternity. The Torah is an eternal word of God and teaching of God. Then the corresponding one, just like Moshe Rabbeinu gives us the Torah, he's good. I see that he's good to become a prophet. I see that he's good to become the Redeemer of Israel. How do I know that good refers to a Redeemer? A Redeemer means that you take someone out of bondage, just like the Jewish people were slaves to a Pharaoh in Egypt. In Kabbalah, we're taught that bondage versus freedom is a property of hope, of this fifth sefirah. Either a person is free or is in bondage. Moses is able to take a soul, into our souls. But if we're in bondage, whether it's physical bondage or spiritual bondage, there comes a soul that is capable to redeem us from our bondage. That's a property in Kabbalah of hold. How do I know that that's called goodness? Because in the book of Ruth, the scroll of Ruth, the Redeemer is called good. The word good is used as the name of the Redeemer. The Redeemer also means one that redeems a woman and marries her. Therefore also redeems a previous husband that died prematurely. So the Redeemer in the book of Ruth is called good. So to be able to redeem and uplift the souls of the Jewish people, to take us out of bondage, that's essential goodness. Once more, these are a pair of goodness. He's good to become a prophet. He's good to become a redeemer. Actually, Pharaoh himself knew that this is the day. His astrologers told him that this is the day that the Redeemer of Israel is going to be born. It also makes it correspond to hope, because there was some sense, even the other side, the wicked side, the evil side, the Pharaoh, also realized that on this day, this is a good day, the best day, for the Redeemer of Israel to be born. Obviously that was in the news, because she was also afraid, everybody was afraid of the decree of Pharaoh. So everybody knew that the astrologers said that this is the day that the Redeemer of Israel will be born. And if she saw her child born, her new babe, so she said, this is the Redeemer of Israel. This one is going to become the Redeemer of Israel. That's all. The next commentary, interpretation, is the soul foundation. Foundation in Kabbalah, and also even in the revealed part of the Torah, has to do with brit milah, with circumcision. So actually it says that Moshe Rabbeinu was born circumcised. And since he was born circumcised, that circumcision, being circumcised, that is his essential goodness. Because about a tzaddik who is circumcised, it says, imu tzaddik ito. Speak to a tzaddik, this is good. Also means that he's good, his very nature. He doesn't have base passions. To be circumcised means that he's very pure in his desires, in his what otherwise animalistic desire, whether it's eating, whether it's sexual desire, he's good, he's a good person, he's good in essence, in his foundation he's good. That's the tov of your soul. The final one is malchut. And the malchut in Kabbalah is one's name. So the sages say that this word good, which appears at the birth of Moshe Rabbeinu, also refers to his very name. That his mother, initially, before he was called Moses, that the daughter of the princess of Egypt, Batya, the daughter of Pharaoh, called him Moses. But before he received that name Moses, the original name that his mother gave him was Tov, good. And name is the one, one's name is the way one appears and one is referred to and called by society around him. And that's his malchut. One's name is one's kingdom. And Moshe Rabbeinu's kingdom, he reigns by his name, good. It's the essence of goodness. So now we went through in very short the seven different interpretations of what that word good means in the context of the birth of Moshe Rabbeinu. And this is actually a whole picture of his, of the character of his heart. The seven attributes of the seven attributes of the heart. So maybe merit to the Moshe Rabbeinu of this generation with all these attributes. And if we think of them, we also have to try to manifest these attributes in ourselves. Because everyone, it says, has a spark of Moshe Rabbeinu inside of him. May this Moshe Rabbeinu be born this week, this very week.